हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल आईआईटी जेईई ओलंपियाड एंड एपी फिजिक्स विद अंबरीश। एंड दिस इज द वेरी फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑन माय चैनल। इन माय चैनल आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग सेवरल चैलेंजिंग प्रॉब्लम्स एंड आई विल बी डीलिंग विद सम ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट्स दैट आर जनरली नॉट डिस्कस्ड इन द मेन स्ट्रीम आईआईटी जेईई बुक्स। एंड आई होप दैट दैट विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर योर ओलंपियाड प्रिपरेशन एंड ऑल्सो टू एन एक्सटेंट इन योर आईआईटी जेईई एडवांस प्रिपरेशन। So without much ado, let me present the first challenge of my channel. So the challenge is titled Moody Bomb. A bomb is projected with a speed u. The bomb is a very moody one. It detonates if and only if its velocity just before hitting the target is v, not more and not less. So it will explode only if its velocity is exactly v before hitting. Okay. So what is the maximum possible distance of the target from the launching point for successful detonation? You can neglect air drag. Exactly, it requires a speed v before detonation. So this is the problem, and you can pause the video for a while. Maybe you can try it for 5 to 10 minutes, and then you can look at the solution just immediately after this. So now let me present to you the solution. Let us say this is the required optimal projectile path. So launching speed is u and landing speed is v, and let's say s is the displacement of the projectile, and let's say the angle between the launching velocity and the landing velocity, let's say that angle is theta. So what can we say? Now since the landing speed is fixed and launching speed is fixed, that means what? Change in potential energy must be fixed. So that means its height is fixed. Okay, so the landing height is automatically fixed just by u and v using the energy conservation equation, that is v square is equal to u square plus 2gh. So energy conservation fixes the landing height. What else we can say? Now by varying the angle of launch, we can adjust the angle between the landing velocity and the launching velocity. So you know that if you throw it vertically upwards, so landing velocity will be just vertically downwards and it will be an angle of 180 degree, and you can also throw it almost horizontally and then there will be some angle, very small angle between u and v. So the point is that by varying u, the direction of u, you can vary the direction of v, and theta is the angle between them. So how we are going to use this fact? So let's start writing the equations. So first equation we can write as v vector minus u vector is equal to gt. So this simply v is equal to u plus at, and g I'm taking as g vector. Okay. So simple equation, v is equal to u plus at. Now what else we can write? You know that total displacement is the average velocity times the time of flight. So let's say small t is the time of flight, then s vector can be written as u plus v by 2 into t. Now how can I proceed with these two equations further? So you know that when there is a vector equation, we can also write a corresponding equation in magnitudes. So what's that equation? So these are the two equations that are written in magnitudes using the vector equations. So from the second equation, you know that 2s by t is u plus v. So that means what? 4s square by t square will be equal to u square plus v square plus 2uv cos theta. Simple vector addition formula and squared form I have written. So u square plus v square plus 2uv cos theta is 4s square by t square. And then from the first equation, this is the vector difference. So you can say that u square plus v square minus 2uv cos theta is the square of the RHS, that is g square t square. Now look at this form, and many of you will be now instinctively thinking how to proceed further, right? Here there is 1 upon t square and here there is a t square, and this is u square plus v square plus 2uv cos theta and u square plus v square minus 2uv cos theta. So automatically, instinctively, what gets to your mind? So you think of multiplying these two equations. So what do you get? A plus b into a minus b, left hand side. So what do you get by multiplying? This is what you get. Okay, so u square plus v square whole square minus 4u square v square cos square theta is 4s square times g square. Now I want to maximize s. So when will this s be maximized? You know that there is a some subtraction term multiplied by cos square theta, and you know that when cos square theta becomes 0, then this will be maximized because u and v are automatically fixed terms. Okay, so I want cos square theta to be 0, and when is that happening? When theta is 90 degree. So we can say that for maximum s, theta must be 90 degree, and the corresponding value of s is u square plus v square by 2g. Okay, so this is the solution to the problem. Now this was a problem in optimization of projectile, and the key idea here is in the optimal trajectories the landing velocity is perpendicular to the launching velocity, and this idea is not just applicable for this problem. We will see that this idea is applicable in so many optimization problems, optimization on an inclined plane, optimization of projectile from a tower, and we'll see all those problems in the upcoming videos. And this is it for now, and my blog is ITJ Olympiad and AP Physics with Ambarish. It's the same YouTube channel name is also this, and my Facebook page name is also same, ITJ Olympiad and AP Physics with Ambarish. And you can subscribe to my channel. For more exciting problems, you can visit this link. So like, share and subscribe to my Facebook page as well as my YouTube channel.